Does your business use a point of sale system, but it doesn't connect directly to QuickBooks Online? If so, you've probably had to manually enter your daily sales, and that's where the Ziout report comes in. It summarizes all your sales, payments, and taxes for the day. In this video, I'll walk you through the entire process from setting up your accounts to recording your daily sales receipt. In this example, we'll use a pet grooming business. They provide grooming services and occasionally sell products such as shampoo and conditioner. We'll use two existing income accounts, services for pet grooming services, and sales of product income for the sale of pet grooming products. We're going to add a credit cards clearing account, which will be used for credit card payments that have been processed and not yet deposited. We're going to click on My Apps and then Accounting and Chart of Accounts. Then we'll click on New Account, and our first account will be called Credit Cards Clearing. The account type will be Other Current Assets, and the detail type will be Other Current Assets, and then we'll save a new. Now we're going to create an overshort expense account. This will be used if a customer overpaid or underpaid. Our account will be called overshort, and the account type will be expenses. Our detail type will be other business expenses, and then we'll save a new. Our final account will be a gift cards liability account. This will be used to record gift cards that have been purchased and will be cleared once the gift cards have been used. Our account name will be gift cards liability. The account type will be other current liabilities, and the detail type will be other current liabilities, and then we'll save. Now we'll add products and services that will link to the accounts that we created. The first service will be pet grooming services. To add products and services, we'll click on the gear icon, and then products and services, then we'll click on create items, and our first item will be pet grooming services. The item type will be service, and for the description, we'll use the same pet grooming services. We're going to map it to the income account called services, and this is not taxable, so we'll click on non-taxable, and then we'll save a new. The first non-inventory item will be pet grooming products. The name will be pet grooming products, and the item type will be a non-inventory item. I'm going to copy the name into the description, and we're going to map it to the sales of product income account. We're using the sales tax category of grooming and hygiene products for animal use, and then we'll save it new. For the taxable products, we're using QuickBooks Online to automatically calculate sales tax based on the location of the business. Another option is to create a sales tax liability account, then record the taxes on the daily sales receipt. Once the taxes are paid, you would reduce this liability account. We'll create non-inventory items for each form of payment, starting with cash. The name will be cash. This is a non-inventory item, and we'll use the same name in the description. We're going to map this to the cash account, and this will be a non-taxable item, and then we'll save a new. Next, we'll add checks and link it to the appropriate account. The name will be checks, and again, this will be a non-inventory item. I'm going to use the same name in the description, and we're going to map this to payments to deposit. We're going to make this non-taxable, so we'll select product marked exempt by its seller, where seller accepts full responsibility, and then we'll save a new. We'll create a non-inventory item for each type of credit card because these may post separately or at different speeds into the bank account. We'll add Visa as our payment form. The name will be Visa. This is a non-inventory item. I'll use the same name in the description, and we're going to map this to our credit cards clearing account. This is a non-taxable item, and then we'll save a new. The same process would be used for each type of credit card, such as American Express, MasterCard, and Discover. Finally, we'll create a non-inventory item for gift cards, which will connect to the gift cards liability account. The name will be gift cards, and this will be a non-inventory item. I'm going to use the same name in the description, and this is going to map to the gift cards liability account, and I'm going to select gift cards that aren't taxable until redeemed, and then save and close. We'll use a Ziout report from October 17th, which contains details about sales, payments, and taxes for that day. We'll create a sales receipt to record the Ziout report details. We're going to click on Create and then Sales Receipt. And the customer name will be Daily Sales. We're going to change the sales receipt date to October 17th. And deposit to will be payments to deposit. Even though this will be a $0 transaction, it's still the best practice to use this account rather than an actual bank account. And now we'll add the details from the Z report. So we'll add pet grooming services for a total of $1,350. And then we have pet grooming products for a total of $59.84. You notice that the box for tax is checked because we set this up as a taxable item. So QuickBooks has calculated the sales tax based on the location of the business at $5.39. And now we'll add the various forms of payment that were used. These will all be entered as negative numbers. So we have cash, and that'll be for -$205.84. And then we're going to enter each check individually. So I'm going to clear this out and then add the name of the customer. So Jenny Miles, and that was check number 132. This will be a negative number, $145. And then we have another check, and that was from Tony Smith. And the check number was 49. And this will be negative $135. We have Visa payments for a total of $375. Discover payments for $499.39. And then the gift cards, and that was for $55. I'm going to uncheck the box for tax because this is not a taxable item. And you'll notice that this is the negative number because it was used as a form of payment. If this was gift cards being purchased, it would be entered as a positive number. So here we can see that the total is $0, and that's because total payments minus total sales brings us to zero. And then we'll record and close. Let's record the payments that were deposited into the bank account. The cash in checks were deposited on October 18th. We'll click on Create and then Bank Deposit. The funds were deposited into the Chase checking account, and that was on October 18th. We're going to select the two checks from the October 17th sales receipt. So we have the check from Jenny Miles and the check from Tony Smith. And then we're going to also add the cash that we received that day. So we'll use daily sales as a customer. The funds are coming from the cash account, and we're depositing a total of $205.84. So the total deposited amount was $485.84, and then we'll save and close. The Visa payments were deposited on October 20th by the merchant processor EasyPay. So we're going to click on Create and then Bank Deposit. The funds were deposited into the Chase checking account, and this was on October 20th. In the Add Funds to the Deposit section, we're going to select the customer, daily sales, and the account, credit cards clearing. This was only for the Visa payments. The Discover payments were deposited on a different date, so this was for $375. And now we need to add the merchant processor fees, so the vendor was EasyPay. And we're going to record the expense to the bank fees and service charges account. This is an expense, so we're entering it as a negative number, so -$8.81. So the actual amount deposited was $366.19. And then we'll save and close. The gift card payment zeroed out the gift card's liability account. When we take a look at the gift card's liability account, we can see that a gift card was purchased on October 2nd for $55. The gift card was redeemed on October 17th for $55, which zeroed out this liability account. Since we'll be recording the daily sales receipt every day, let's create a template that we can reuse. We're going to click on the gear icon and then recurring transactions and then the new button. The transaction type will be sales receipt. And we're going to call this template daily sales. This will be an unscheduled template. The customer name will be daily sales. And the deposits to, payments to deposit account. Then we'll start adding what we sell. So we have pet grooming services and pet grooming products. All of the payments will be added as a negative number for the quantity. So we'll add cash, and this will be -1, so it'll calculate as a negative number. Then we have checks, and this will be -1. and we're using two forms of credit card payments. So we have the Visa and Discover payments. And occasionally the gift cards. And that'll also be as a negative number. And we're going to enter this as a non-taxable item. And then we'll save the template. When you're ready to use the template, you'll click on Use. And then you'll change the sales receipt date to the date on the Z-Out report. And you'll add the details about the services and products that were purchased, as well as the payment forms that were used on that date, and then record and close. The daily sales receipt is essential to capture business activity and to ensure that all sales, taxes, and payment methods from the Z report are recorded accurately. What type of business are you tracking daily sales for? Let me know in the comments. I love hearing how different businesses use this setup.